Hey YouTubers, Jason here with River City Graphics, and I thought since we're waiting for Bob to post a video and check out all the excitement in Kentucky Jets, thought I would do a video for you guys with how we made the graphics for the Thunderbirds Thunder Chief, especially the logo. There seems to be a lot of interest on how we can make these masks so accurate. So I'm kind of going to go through that for you right now. But first of all, I think it's important to talk about the difference between raster and vector, or bitmapped images and vector. I do all my graphics work in Illustrator, which is a vector program. It's Adobe Illustrator. Most of you are probably familiar with it. There are others out there like CorelDRAW, and even AutoCAD is a vector program, if you will. What the difference is like Photoshop is a raster program or a bitmap program. Is it edits pixels, which is dots, kind of useless for our purposes. We need to edit in lines on an X and Y coordinate. These are just two-dimensional drawings, and they're a series of lines. If I knock the color out of this, these are already raster images. We'll just knock the color out, and we'll just go straight to vector here. Cooperate. There we go. You'll see now that these are now just in rasters, just a series of lines. And this information is easily read by digital plotters, where they can be drawn on paper, or if you can put a knife in there, they can be cut into vinyl and stencil mask material. So this is how this is done. It's really quite simple, although there's no direct output in Illustrator to interface into cutting equipment. These files can be saved to disk, or if you're on a network, you can send them over to a RIP computer that has the cut software in it that accept these vector files in vintage EPS formats, and they'll transfer right over to your cutter. And the neat thing about these files is they can be emailed to other people in any corner of the world for them to buy from you if you're a designer, and they can be cut in their own software. And I've been doing this for a number of years in both models and full-scale production for graphics, helicopters, trucks, jeeps, you name it. We've done it all. We've also done a lot of models, too. A lot of difficult things that people can't buy. You know, it has to be custom-made. And this example of this F-105 Thunderbird's thud is a fine example of that. So I'm just going to kind of run through how we design these and how we make the masks briefly. Some of you are interested in this, so I thought it'd be fun to make a video. I used to have a video capture software like Camtasia or something for this kind of thing, but I don't have that software anymore, so we're just going to have to film it directly on the monitor. I hope you can see it. I'll have to talk a little bit or turn your volume up so you can hear me, because the camera's a little bit away from the computer. And I'll try to keep the frame centered in the shot, you know, so and don't do something goofy like that, and that'll make it difficult for you to see. But as you can see right here, I just called up a circle. Now I go to the circle tool, and you know, hold your shift button down so it makes the circle proportional. You know how that's done, right? Okay, so we just make a circle, and then I made these little rectangular shapes, and they were centered by, you know, calling up the show rulers, and you know, you can grab these ruler lines down and put them to anywhere you want from left and right to help, you know, line up things like these little rectangles on the circle, so you know that they're exactly straight. You know, they're where they need to be. But for the most part, they're just a reference tool anyway, because they're all going to be the same when we're done on every one of the masks that represent each color. So once you got these tabs on here, they're just kind of they're separate images now. So there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 separate images right here. As you can see, that if we ran this through the cutter now, we'd put a cut line right there, and that's not what we want. So we need to grab this entity now, all of it. Now the computer recognizes this all as one entity, and we'll come over here and we'll push the merge button. On some computers, this is called weld on some vector programs. Now you see it's welded it all together in one giant shape that can be easily cut and recognized, excuse me, by plotter software, or by the plotter itself. Now everything gets a lot simpler. I'll switch back over to the color mode so it's a little more easier for you to identify everything. Again, the orange represents the masking material that I'm currently working with, and you've seen a lot of that over in Bob's shop. Now I'll grab the Thunderbird logo, And this basically just needs to be, you know, it can be anywhere in here. Doesn't matter where. Ideally, you just probably want to put it in the middle somewhere. It doesn't have to be that technical, because at the end of the day, all of these masks are going to be exactly the same. Okay? Because they're all going to be cut from this one mask once you get it done the way you want. Now, when I click this off, you're not going to see it, because if you want to be able to see it, we'll just go back up, edit undo, and I'll call up a separate layer right here. See, the first layer is on the top. So now I can cut this, which is just, you know, your simple control C. Take this one out of this layer. Wait a minute. Control X. It just removes it. Well, we'll pop up to this layer. Control V. And now it popped it back in. And we can see it now because it's on the top layer. So that's just a little tip. But it wouldn't matter in layers when you just knock the color out of everything. You can see everything in lines. But some people like to work in color, and it doesn't really matter to me. I can do it either way. But anyway, now we're at a point here where we can start making the mask. Because the mask is done, and that's how it would look if it were painted, with the exception of the star being white. And I'm not going to mess around with that right now. So my goal here is just to get this done as briefly as possible so you can kind of get an idea of what we're doing. So we'll go ahead and control copy this whole thing. And I think it's imperative to copy it as a unit, all of them. So we'll copy and paste. We're going to need 5 of these. I'll paste another one. And I'm going to try to get them all in a row here just to try to keep things organized. Now you can kind of see where I'm going here, I think. Because they've all been copied from the... Where'd that one run off to? Well, he didn't go. There he is. They've all been copied from the mother graphic. I always like to keep the mother graphic up here. Keep it out of the way so you can refer to it later. Okay? So now we're gonna need... I'll make just one more of these. These are all still mother graphics now. I'm going to make one more, just so we have an extra one down here if we need it. Now what we do is we zoom in here and we delete the things that we don't need, because you're going to start dealing with your mask. And what was the first color that Bob used? Well, it was the white. So we're going to go ahead and delete everything here but the white background. Okay. And that's a double line right there, and we only need the outer one, so I'll delete the inner one, and we'll go back to the colorized version. I know it's black now because that's just part of that black outline that was there before, so you can select that if it helps you remember what's going on. To make that white, you can do that too, and now see, it's white. You're good to go. All right, back and back out again. We'll go over to the next one here. And that one, I believe, was red that Bob used. So we'll just delete everything but what was red. Pretty simple. Now, on the next one, I think that we'll keep that one, the blue one. So we'll delete everything but what is blue. How's that? And I suppose probably moving forward, a guy could probably, when you're painting that eye on that eagle, shoot some white on there first so that yellow can stand out a little bit, because Bob had a little trouble with that yellow on top of the blue. But you can always shoot a little bit of white under those lighter colors, and it helps them pop a little bit more. Okay, so what color are we at next here? I think we'll just keep the beak this time and the eye, and we'll delete everything else. And there we go. That looks great. All right. Now we're going to keep the Thunderbird's logo here. We're going to delete everything else but all things that are black. And I'm even going to go back to the wireframe. Okay, so we have to do something special on this one. And this is how this border turned out so perfect on Bob's artwork, is that I went in here. Now I'll delete this line again. Delete. Okay, and it's gone. Now, if you remember, the white one now is exactly the same as this. So this would line up with that one. We don't want it to. We want our black border to fall in between the white. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and click on this right here. And I'm going to call up a stroke. And I want to call it about, let's go back. Stroke is a technical term for an outline in this business. And we'll go ahead and call up that's the stroke right there, and it looks pretty good. We'll go ahead now and come up here and hit expand, fill, expand, and I'll show you what that did. Is that put the stroke right in between the line, so it's given me a line on the outside of the white and a line on the inside of the white. And so if I come up in here, and if I delete that middle line now, I'll have to ungroup it because they're all together. And I knew that. Edit, ungroup. Now I can come in here and select that middle line and delete it and get it out of there. Delete all of it. Now I know that when this mask is applied over top of the, need that black line in there either on the beak one. Get that out of there. These little dots are nothing. They're just little X's so the computer has reference points, but they don't cut or print. So don't worry about these little X's, these little dots. It's not going to show up on anything. Now the white one, okay? Sometimes these look a little funny in color. There's the red. There's the blue, there's the beak, here's the black, which will allow the white part to fall right in the middle of that line. That gives you a bit of a micro margin when you're trying to line that black border up on there like Bob showed you in the video, where that white ends up splitting the difference between that black line. And using these tabs here that I have, as he did, by putting tape here and here after you lay down the first one, allows you to line these up so perfectly and so precisely that I probably really don't even need to do that. But it does give you a bit of a micro margin of a few thousandths of an inch both ways. So that black line will definitely end up covering the white all the way around. And will end up making the logo look near absolutely perfect. And there you have it. That's how we do these graphics here, these masks. It is fairly simple, but it's also still kind of a little bit complex. We don't need this one here on the end. The extra one I thought we would need. It's just a five-color mask, and it's quite simple. And then here's the mother mask right here. And you can save this file now and pull these up at any time you want. And if you wanted them bigger, you just grab them all, hit your shift button down, and you can make them bigger, or you can make them smaller. It doesn't matter. That's the beauty of vector. You all know by playing around with pictures, when you start enlarging them, they get pixely. And the crappier the camera you use, the more pixely pictures become when you reduce them or make them larger and start messing around with them. You do not have that problem with vector images. You can zoom in on this so close, so tight. These images always stay crystal clear, sharp and crisp. That's the beauty of vector. So, I'm giving you guys a big education today in the world of graphics. Actually, this graphic here was before I made the changes, because these are F-16s, and I did put F-105s in Bob's when I actually cut them. So, you're noticing that these are these are F-16s. But we did make that change on the one Bob's got. So, it's good to go.
And basically the whole mask for the whole entire plane is basically done largely the same way as I just showed you. We use photographs of the real thing, and over top of the photographs, we overlay these images to get everything exactly right. That's how it's done. I'm giving up all my secrets here, because I want you people to understand that you can do this too. And I'm telling you what, don't go to a sign shop and expect them to do this stuff for you, because they're not going to do it. They don't have the time. If a sign shop doesn't have something in a clip art book they can cut out for you in 5 minutes, they ain't going to mess with it. Here's the beauty of this. Adobe Illustrator is not that expensive of a program. You can buy older versions, CS2, CS3. You don't have to go out and buy the brand new CS6, which is about $400 or $500. But you can get these vector programs. CorelDRAW is a little cheaper yet, I think, too. You can get these vector-based programs online. I think there's a couple free ones out there, too. Inkscape is another vector program. It's free online. Inkscape. Try that one. You can design all your graphics in there, put them on a disk, take them to a sign shop. They won't charge you a setup design fee or anything. They'll just charge you the vinyl that you use to make the sticker because you've got all your stuff already designed. That's the beauty of learning these tools and these software, is that you can, you know, become your own designer, design your own graphics, and then just take them into a sign shop, and they're more than happy to cut this stuff for you as long as they don't have to do the design work. That's what takes a lot of time, and it's quite a process to get it and get it right. The mask for the star in the bar that I made for Bob in the U.S. Air Force, and I'm going to go ahead and edit these and put little tabs on these and make sure they're all the same, so when next time somebody does a star in the bar, all these are going to line up. Bob kind of struggled with that, but we're getting this lineup system figured out now, so it won't be such a struggle. We did edit this mask, too, and we ended up making it about 10 inches longer through here. And then there's more space between the white, so it fits the model a little better. I knew that there would have to be some editing that Bob had to do with the mask to make it work, but we ended up being real close, and we made adjustments on the mask that's currently in another file that I have, so it's all ready to go for anybody else that wants. This was before the adjustments. The other file's on my computer in the shop where the cutter is, and that's where I did all the editing and changed it on the rip machine there. So this is that actually just the rough file, but it's up here in my office where it's a little nicer up here, and I tend to do a little bit more mess around. I wanted to make this video for you. I wanted to just see the process and kind of give you an explanation of how we do it. I don't have anything to hide here. I certainly don't have any trade secrets, and modeling is something that you know, we should share and enjoy together. I don't have any problem doing design files for people either, so my fees are pretty reasonable on that. So if you need something designed, then you can just take it to your local guy that has a cutter. These cutters are not expensive anymore. With all these massive printer wrap machines that are out, these cutters are kind of falling by the wayside. A lot of these companies like these big printed wraps and stuff. Yes, I've seen those put on models too. That stuff tends to get a little bit heavy, you know, because it's got a laminate on it too. So, you know, unless it's a real super lightweight jet and you can get away with adding a little bit more weight, those wraps tend to be a little bit heavy for models. I do a lot of that stuff. I design a lot of them, and I have them outsourced because I don't have the large format printer. But my point is, because of the popularity of the wrapped vehicles and trailers and stuff like that, the cutters that are out there just don't get used much anymore, and a lot of sign shops are getting rid of them. You could probably go on eBay and find one out there for a little or nothing, and I'm telling you, the cutters are still perfectly great for making paint masks and doing vinyl graphics for the models. I think that they even tend to work a little bit better than the wrap machines, the printed stuff. The printed stuff, especially when it comes to making masks, I mean, you know, your masks, when you paint it on, don't hide all the details that a sticker or a decal does. So that's the way I see it. You know, Bob still retained all of his rivet detail around that Thunderbird logo,
And that's what really looks great, is when you can make these masks and make them look good and paint through them, and it still retains all the panel lines and the details of the aircraft. And some of that printed sticker stuff doesn't, you know, you lose some of that detail, which is fine on warbirds and things like that, fifth scale type models and, you know, Piper Cubs and things like that. It's just not a big deal with that sort of stuff. But when you're looking for these real high-end projects, you know, someone spends $10,000, $15,000 on a jet, you know, what's a few more $100 for some quality paint masks, the way I see it. But I'm kind of rambling here, so I will let you go. I hope you all enjoyed this. It's kind of fun. And we'll talk to you later. This is Jason from River City Graphics. And my email address is rcflyboy01@yahoo.com. If you need any graphics or need some design work done, I can just send you the design files, and I just charge a flat rate by the hour for that service. So send us an email. We'll be glad to help you out. Thanks.